Ah, Ian King, for an altimeter, for testing the Bendix and data computer. The altimeter should be compliant with the Ring 565. I found this one on eBay a few weeks ago. This is an altimeter which was installed in a DC-10 or MD-80 aircraft. This is a long instrument. This is an altimeter from Sperry. You can see the reference here. I didn't see, but this one is compliant with the Ring 575. The standard Ring 575 is a digital standard. Actually, it is very close to the Ring 429, so it is not possible to use this altimeter with the Bendix and data computer. On the front, there is an adjustment of the pressure, as usual, in millibars on the left, or inches of mercury on the right. There is an index here. Okay, and a circular connector on the rear. So first, let's see what is inside. There are only two screws to unscrew. Look at that. This altimeter is quite complex. This thing is gorgeous. So we have on the front an electromechanical assembly. So this is the servo control, obviously, with a DC motor. Okay, so we can see here two synchro resolvers. This is not common. Okay, so this seems to be the feedback. Okay, so it seems that there is a coarse synchro and a fine synchro. Here we have the power supply transformer, and we have here a very big potentiometer. There are some specific values written on this potentiometer. Yeah, so this one is used actually for the reference pressure. And we have here a solenoid for the flag. You can see that the glass is a little bit broken here. And we have on the rear six electronic boards. So we can see here we have some logic ICs, probably for the digital bus, Ring 575. And we have here three analog electronic boards. Okay, so let's see the boards. So we need to remove this metallic bar here. Unfortunately, I don't have the suitable Allen key for this screw, so it is quite complicated. Okay, I succeeded to remove one screw, this one. But the other one is difficult, and this screw is damaged also. So it will be difficult. Okay, so we try to remove the rear plate here. Okay, look at that. Okay, so we can see that there is a flat flex for the connection between the connectors and the electronic boards. Okay, so let's have a look on the electronic boards. Let's start with this one. Okay, so there is an insulator between each board. Okay, so there is a 2N4036 and a 2N2102. And it seems that we don't have any conformal coating. So this is a good thing for the reverse engineering. Yeah, thank you very much. We can see that we have two zener diodes here. Some power was dissipated on that area. There is a change on the color of the material here. We have two ICs here. Military logic IC 5400, NAND gates, and 5404 X inverters. Okay, let's see the second board. On that board, there are a few op-amps and some transistors and passive parts. Yeah, the op-amps have a specific marking, dead code 86. The part number of this one is GLDA 365. And the other one's SL62514. Okay, on this one, there are also a few op-amps and two logic ICs, 54121, two monostable, so this is probably a CTP, but I'm not sure. Okay, and now we have three digital boards for the ERINC 575 interface bus. First, this one. Okay, so you have one counter here, 4 bits counter, and several logic gates, 5400, 5420, 2 5420, another one, and a monostable here. You can see the capacitor associated, and we have one transistor. Oh, it's not a transistor, it's an op-amp. Cell 20346. Another board with logic ICs. And the last one. So we can see that we have two ICs. So I think that there are two comparators. One comparator should be used for the positive pulse and the second one for the negative pulse. This is the front end for the ERINC 575, I guess. And there is a part here from National SD10861. And this reference is obscure. Okay, so I found that the motor is connected to this board actually. Okay, so there is one contact here. The second one is here. So I think that the first board here is the power supply board, probably. As you can see, we have two zener diodes, two resistors, so this is for plus or minus something. So the servo control amplifier is on that board. Maybe these two transistors are used for the power stage. Yeah, so there are two complementary transistors. You can see that the base of each transistor connected together, and also the emitter here. Okay, so this is a push-pull configuration. The idea is to start with that board, because we know where the motor is connected. After that, we can find the input of the servo control amplifier, and from that point, we should have a summing point with the feedback and the input voltage. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time for the next episode. Bye bye.